everybody, this is Sapphire and Steel. This is assignment 5. This is part 3 of this story. I am interested a lot in this. Don't really know what's going on. There seems to be kind of a mashup of time, present, past. A man who's dead has appeared, possibly out of a portrait of him that's in a living room. The people that are in this house at this party, this celebratory party, have decided to pretty much play hide and seek, yet a young girl is now dead. There's somebody within the house, or there's an entity within the house that I believe has obviously killed her. We've seen their shoes, but we don't really know who they are yet. And everyone seems to be getting people mixed up. There's a young man who keeps getting called Malcolm, but Malcolm was his dad, and everyone's memory is basically all over the place. I'm really looking forward to getting on into this, so let's go. I have a feeling she feels it when the girl dies, hence this.
Anyone else in there with you?
Oh, thunder tops it off as well.
We weren't going to play murders till after dinner. She's not playing, is she, Arthur?
Did it kill Veronica? Or did someone in this house do it?
It could be one and the same.
Poor, poor, lovely girl.
Felix, ring for the police, will you?
The only way out of this house is through the front door, isn't it, really?
Everyone is going to have to remember just exactly where they were and what they were doing.
When?
Within the last...
10 minutes?
To
bed. Yeah, it's evidence.
It's one of ours, one of our carving knives. I laid it in the dining room earlier this evening, sir.
That would make it accessible to anyone.
Quick, what's my name?
Miles.
Miles.
Thank you. Howard?
Yeah, but what about the guy from the picture?
Did you get the police, Felix?
No, I couldn't.
Why not?
The telephone's dead.
Anyway, we're not cut off. Mr. Harborough, sir. And now the rest of us had better start.
Are they even going to be allowed to leave?
Hard, I'm going upstairs.
The door's locked. It's impossible, sir.
What the hell?
Fog. Smash the window.
That's why the batteries in the device wouldn't open the
door.
There's
no way out.
I think it's Emma.
Which one of them killed her? Which one of them does it control?
Oh, they're gonna get him now.
Oh, it's you. Look, the phone's dead, Matt.
Using this house. It says here that it's on a ley line. The line runs right across this part of the country and... Tony Purnell's champagne glass. It's his last physical contact.
Fast cars. Expensive clothes.
Lots of women.
Money. June the 18th.
He said he hadn't
this
been
year.
Here for a while.
Who did he come to see? Mulreen?
No. No, he was in London. In Mulreen's office. Here. Behind that green door. They're kissing. He says Veronica will not be a threat.
Put himself
he
in the frame.
He can easily get rid of her.
Is that a hook shot?
Where?
What on earth?
What the hell?
What is it, Greville?
There's no sign of Mr. Purnell at the back of the house, sir.
There's no sign
of
him anywhere.
None of the servants have seen him.
No one can get out.
Now, look here. I want to know what the devil's going on. For starters, I want to know who you
who
two
are. You?
A tear in the fabric of time. I read somewhere that the inability to remember is one of the symptoms.
I went to my club, the Denver, for lunch, and in the evening I went to the theatre. The Knightsbridge Tivoli to...
Impossible.
Are you calling me a liar?
And the Denver was, I believe, blitzed in 1941.
You see?
It's some sort of country trick.
Is it?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Assuming that there is an outside to the house.
And is that storm real?
If Greville would be kind enough...
Of course, sir.
...to remove the sheet from the body.
She couldn't have put it there.
She's gone back
and
to the
present. And now she's gone and Tony Purnell's disappeared.
There is a logic to it somewhere.
Rubbish.
You see, Lord Mulrine provided the setting. A party. A celebration back in 1930.
The summer solstice.
No, it's all very significant. June the 21st, 1930.
You can't get in anyway.
It's locked.
Tony Purnell may be in there. Nobody's locked, have they?
We're talking about George McDee.
You know, biology and all that stuff. These are ludicrous.
Genetic engineering.
Serum biology.
Yes.
What was he doing, Sapphire?
Manipulating the genetic characteristics of a virus. It will save thousands of lives. One more day, Steele. He will cause the extinction of life on this planet by his carelessness.
Oh, so shit.
June the 20th... Got a little bit of a problem.
Oh, God, a little bit of a problem, says Emma.
It's about dinner. Is nobody hungry?
I think Emma is slightly cuckoo. Why is he...
Mr. Purnell, sir, they've been looking for you.
Yes, I know.
You all right, sir?
Don't trust the butler, though.
He must have had this in his hands at some time or other.
Uh-huh.
He's asking for a manifestation.
Yes, published in 1920.
Well, it's too difficult.
Yes? What do you want?
To talk.
Well, I've no time for that. I've work to do.
Dioxyribonucleic acid, Mr. McDee.
What?
The transference of coded genetic material.
It's to the millions who may die without my vaccine.
Such laboratory procedures must be carefully controlled.
They are!
But is it not possible for a strain of bacteria not only to withstand
that.
The change in temperature, but also to become immune?
Are you one of Alec Fleming's lot?
Others will come later. They will find a means to control and use genetic engineering.
I sincerely hope
you
so.
You don't have the facility.
Hiding.
He said that he wanted to see you, sir.
Don't go.
Of course, Greville.
Nobody else.
What
oh,
is it?
God.
Listen.
You told me.
Where are the others, Howard and Felix?
Felix went upstairs to get some cigarettes. And I thought Howard was in the library.
No. Oh, bloody hell.
Oh, yes, there's a reason for all of it. The time change, the murders, the barrier around this house.
It's just very difficult for Miles to pinpoint.
That was quite an abrupt ending to that episode. I didn't expect it to end there. I was waiting for it to continue. I'm so intrigued by this. It's so interesting. I've loved every single assignment so far. I need to kind of know what's going on, because obviously we've got this guy who's creating this genetic makeup or this in order to create a vaccine, but obviously shit goes south and he has to die because of it. But then we've got Sapphire and Steele who can't really pinpoint who it is. I still think Emma's involved. I definitely think she's involved because the shadow on the floor in Tony's room looked like it should have been Emma. I think Howard might be involved in this in some way as well, just because the way he was with his grandmother last episode when he took her to rest. I don't know, there's so many people that it could be, but that's what's brilliant about it. It's like a Poirot episode, really. I think I might go watch the next part and I'll see you guys soon, so thank you.